Today we will study properties of a good estimator. Before studying it, we should be clear what is estimator. We study for the population, but it is not easy to study the whole population because its size is very large. So we derive some samples from the population and calculate the statistics. And these statistics are the estimators. And we are making the estimates of the parameter. For example, we take a case of a regression model. This is yt is equal to b0 plus b1 xt. Here yt is the dependent variable which is dependent on xt, and b0 and b1 are the population parameters. But since it is difficult to calculate the parameters, we derive a sample and calculate these values b0 and b1 from the sample. These are distinguished as b0 hat and b1 hat. These are the estimators and these are the estimates of the parameter. There are certain properties of a good estimator which it must possess to apply for the whole population. The first property is unbiasedness. Unbiasedness, when the estimated value of B, this is B hat, is equal to the actual value of the population parameter, that is B. If these two values are equal, this is called unbiased estimator. If there is if the difference between the two estimate these two values is not equal to zero, then the estimator is called biased. Unbiasedness means the difference between the estimated value of B and the actual value of B is equal to zero. Next property is minimum variance estimator. This is also known as best estimator. It means when the variance of the estimator, estimated value, is minimum as compared, suppose we have calculated the B value through OLS method, ordinary least square method. There are certain other methods also to calculate the value of B. Suppose this is the other method. If the variance of B cap is less than variance of B, this one, then the estimator is called best estimator. It may be possible that the estimator is unbiased, but it does not possess the property of minimum variance. For example, in the case of first diagram, the estimator, this is expected value of B is equal to the true value of B, but the variance, this one, is larger than the variance in this diagram. But here the estimated value of B is not equal to the true value of B. So it might be possible that any estimator may contain the property of unbiasedness but not the property of best estimator. Next property comes in this line also. This is the efficient estimator. The estimator is called efficient when it possesses the property of unbiasedness and best. This is the expected, the estimated value of B is equal to the actual value of B, and the variance of B is least, minimum than the variance calculated by other method. Next property is linear estimator. This is the, if the estimator is the linear function of the independent variable, this is called linear estimator. This is considered with the help of an example. Suppose we need to calculate yi or mean value of y. For that we add all the values of y and divide it by the number of observations. Here we take out 1 by n outside the bracket and calculate the value of y bar. Here 1 upon n is the weights assigned to all the yi's. this 1 upon n is the linear function of y. Suppose we assign 1 upon n as k, then y bar is calculated by k yi. K is the linear function of yi. So this is the property of linear estimator. Next property is blue estimator. Blue refers to best linear unbiased estimator. Best means minimum variance. Linear means the linear estimator is the linear function of independent variable, and unbiasedness is the difference between the estimated value and the actual value of the parameter is equal to zero. When the estimator possesses all the three properties, this is known as blue estimator. This is a very important property. Next property is sufficient estimator. An estimator is sufficient that utilizes all the information a sample contains about the true parameter. It must use all the observations of the sample. For example, arithmetic mean is sufficient because it considers all the values of the sample, while in the case of median and mode, they do not utilize all the information of a sample, rather they are the positional averages. So the estimator calculated using the arithmetic mean is called the sufficient estimator. Next property is minimum mean square error estimator. It is a combination of unbiasedness and the minimum variance properties. An estimator is a minimum mean square error estimator if it has the smallest mean square error, defined as the expected value of the square differences of the estimator around the true population parameter B, as shown in the formula. MSE, mean square error of B, is equal to expected value of B1, B cap minus B ka whole square. Now the question arises, which is the most important property of an estimator? In fact, there is not a single property which is considered to be the most important. We need to have the combination of the two or more properties. For example, blue and MSE. If these two properties are combinedly if the estimator has these two properties, blue and mean square error, this is considered to be the best estimator or the good estimator for the population parameter.